Hello everyone, myself Sanjay A.Utage, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to discuss Sequential Logic Circuits Part 1, Learning Outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to analyze various sequential logic circuits. Outline, introduction, sequential logic circuits, asynchronous circuits, synchronous circuits, question, answer, flip-flops, references. Introduction. In combinational logic circuits, output values depend on their present input values. Sequential logic is a type of logic circuit whose output depends not only on the present value of its input signals, but on the sequence of past inputs, the input history as well. Input history is stored in the memory element. Sequential logic circuits compute a function in a series of steps. Use the result of one step as an input to the next circuit that can sample a value, a signal that says when to sample. Sequential logic circuit. This is the block diagram. Here, this is the combinational logic circuit having input and the output. Addition to this circuit, there is one more block shown as a memory block. This memory block has one input as the previous output from the combinational logic circuit and another input which is called as clock signal, which is a train of clock rectangular pulses. The output of the memory is fed back to the combination logic circuit. So sequential logic circuit is inherently contains a combination logic circuit as well as a memory element. The output will respond the input only when the memory will give the output. The memory will give the output signal only when the previous output is present and the most important, the clock is present. So if the clock is absent, output of the memory will be absent, output of the final output sequential logic circuit will be absent. Digital sequential logic circuits are divided into synchronous and asynchronous types. In synchronous sequential circuits, the state of the device changes only at discrete times in response to a clock signal. In asynchronous circuits, the state of the device can change at any time in response to the changing input. So it means synchronous type circuit requires a clock signal to change its output, whereas asynchronous doesn't require a clock signal to change the output. So this is the main difference. Synchronous sequential logic. In a synchronous circuit, an electronic oscillator called a clock or clock generator generates a sequence of repetitive pulses called the clock signal, which is distributed to all the memory elements in the circuit. The basic memory element in sequential logic is the flip-flop. The output of each flip-flop only changes when triggered by the clock pulses. So changes to the logic signals throughout the circuit all begins at the same time at regular intervals synchronized by the clock. Asynchronous sequential logic. These circuits do not have clock circuit. When one event is completed, next event occurs. Such circuits have feedback path for finding internal state, that is, present output for generating successive output. A delay circuit or flip-flop is required for this purpose. The output of all the storage elements, that is flip-flops, in the circuit at any given time, the binary data they contain is called the state of the circuit. This is the comparison between the combination circuit and sequential circuit. So a combinational circuit will have n number of inputs. In response to the n number of inputs, it will give m number of outputs. Whereas a sequential circuit, it contains a combinational circuit having input and output, but moreover it contains a memory block with a memory block having one input, that is the feedback from the previous output and the clock. Flip-flop. In electronics, a flip-flop or latch is a circuit that has two stable states and can be used to store state information, a bistable multivibrator. The circuit can be made to change state by signals applied to one or more control inputs and will have one or two outputs. At the basic storage element in a sequential logic, flip-flops and latches are fundamental building blocks of a digital electronics system used in computers, communications, and many other types of systems. Flip-flop can be either level-triggered, asynchronous, transparent, or opaque, or edge-triggered, synchronous, or clock. In level-triggered, flip-flop can be triggered either at logic 0 level or logic 1 level. Edge-triggered means flip-flop is triggered either going from 0 to 1 or positive going edge or negative going edge. Flip-flops can be divided into common types, the SR, set reset, D, data or delay, T, toggle, and JK flip-flops. The behavior of a particular type can be described by what is termed the characteristics equation, which derives the next, that is after the next clock pulse output, Q next, that is the next output, in terms of the input signals and or the current output. So this is the basic SR flip-flop built using 4 NAND gates. Clock, let us consider that this clock will be always at logic 1 level. So S and R are the two inputs, Q and Q bar, these are the two complement outputs. Let us consider the first case, S0, R0, both are 0. According to the property of the NAND gate, the output will be 1 only when the output must be when the one of the two inputs is equals to 0. So this NAND gate 1 and NAND gate 2 will have both outputs equals to 1. Now let us assume that Q is 0, Q bar is 1. So Q is 0, this 0 is coming over here, this is 1. So input to this NAND gate is 1, 0, output is must be 1. This one going over here, 1, 1, the output is 0. It means that the previous state was 0, 1 and the next is 0, 1. It means that for SR flip-flop, when S is equals to R is equals to 0, there is no change in the output. Now let us consider this S is equals to 1 and R is equals to 0. So this R input is 0, this must be 1, this must be 0. So this is 0, let us assume that this is 0 and 1. This 0 and 1, this 1, 1, 0, 0 and 1, this is 1. So when S is equals to 1, R equals to 0, and the previous state is 0, 1, the output will change to 1, 0. So this is called as set state of the flip-flop. Next is the S0 R R1, the output will change to Q0 and Q bar equals to 1. This is called as reset state. Now, when S is equals to 1 and R equals to 1, when both the clock, this NAND gate will have 1-1, this will also get 1-1, so output will be 0-0. These two NAND gates will have one input will as 0, so they both will be try to become 1, which is prohibited. Okay. Next is the symbol of a SR flip flop. This is the truth table what we discussed. For S00 01 01 01 10 10 11, this is a prohibited condition. Exercise assignment. What is the drawback of SR flip-flop? The answer is, when both S and R are equals to 1, the output is prohibited. Okay, this condition is not allowed because all the last two gates will try to become 1. Output Q and Q bar will try to become 1, which is prohibited. So this is the JK flip-flop. The drawback of the SR flip-flop when S and R both equals to 1 is been eliminated in this JK flip-flop. In the JK flip-flop, which is similar to the SR flip-flop, in which for both the J and K 0, the output is no change. J 1, K 0, output is 1, like a set condition. J 0, K 1, output is 0, reset condition. When J equals to 1, K equals to 1, output will toggle, that is Q bar. It means that for every clock pulse, the output will change between 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. So this is the difference between the this. So this is J and K flip-flop. With J0, K1, J0, K1, the Q bar is 1. Okay, here, now J is 1 and K is 1, the output is became 1 during the first clock pulse. Second clock pulse, both 1, 1, output will now change to 0. So in this way, the output will toggle. This is the references. Thank you.